listening to Chi Chi's radio show.
Welcome, everyone. It's currently nighttime at Chi Chi's Cheesy Cafe, and Chi Chi's up late, busy working on something. Let's go see what she's up to.
What's up, guys? I've been preparing this show for hours now. A school wanted to take their kids on a field trip to my cafe, and I really want to blow them away. I just need to find something I can put here to keep the kids entertained while we dress for the big finale. But me and Kane will both be getting ready, so I don't know what to do.
It would be useful if we had more attractions at the cafe, but so far it's just me and you.
Yeah. Maybe we should sleep on it and see if we have any ideas in the morning.
Sure. Night, Gigi.
Night, Kane.
I wish we had more friends who could stay at the cafe. Wait, I might know someone who can help. You must be getting some weird phone calls.
Kane! Oh my god! I am so sorry! How's it been? We haven't spoken since October.
Yeah, we haven't. I was actually looking for a favor.
What is it?
Well, we need some entertainment for 5 minutes during the show tomorrow. Would you be able to do it?
Wow. That's a big ask. But I'll do it!
Oh, thank you so much! I just hope Gigi will approve of this.
I'm sure she will. I'll head over there tomorrow morning to practice. I have a cool number I've been working on.
Perfect. See you then.
Bye.
I should probably get some sleep now. Tomorrow's gonna be a big day. I'm coming. Welcome to our cafe, Chi-Chi.
Looks nice. Where's everyone else?
Oh, it's just me and Chi-Chi here.
Oh, that's sad. Maybe I should move in here so you two actually have someone else to keep you company.
Huh. That would be really nice.
Who else am I hearing? Hey, Chipmunk Chi-Chi. How's it going, girl?
Good. You can just call me Chi-Chi.
Yeah, but with both of us here, it might get confusing.
I guess.
So are you here to see the show?
Better. Gigi is going to be out in between her before the finale.
Wait, what?
Yeah, Kane offered me the job last night.
How come you didn't consult me before doing this?
Because you were asleep and you had been up all night brainstorming.
That doesn't mean you go behind my back like this.
I thought you were approved since she's technically just you from an alternate universe.
But she's a chipmunk. And I never told the school there would be a chipmunk performing here.
And what the problem with that be?
Oh, I don't know. A kid might be allergic.
To chipmunks?
Maybe.
Should I go?
No.
Yes!
Gigi's performing, and that's fine.
Fine. I'll let the school know. And if we have to cancel the show, you'll be the one to blame.
I'm sorry about her. She's very tired from last night. You just get set up.
But what if I can't perform?
I know you'll be okay. I don't even think there's such a thing as a chipmunk allergy.
Okay, then.
Principal Doris, how may I help you?
Hi, Doris. It's me, Chi-Chi. There's been a slight change to the performance schedule for today. Kane brought in Chipmunk Chi-Chi, but I wasn't sure if that would be okay, you know, with kids and allergies and...
Chi-Chi, I'm okay with that change. Now the kids are allergic and they probably will be excited to see her. They constantly play those kinds of songs on the smart board, so I think we'll be okay.
Oh! Perfect! I'll see you in a few hours!
Yes, see you then!
I shouldn't have yelled at them like that. I need to apologize!
Chi-Chi, what's wrong?
I'm sorry I yelled at you earlier. Hope you're not mad at me.
It's okay, Chi-Chi. I forgive you.
Me too.
I'll make sure to run changes by you in the future.
Thanks, Kane.
That's all well and good, but we've got a show in a few hours, so let's start rehearsing.
Sounds like a plan to me.
So the three got a rehearsing and the others were amazed at Chipmunk Chi-Chi's act. And the school kids agreed too. They loved every bit of the show and the three of them loved every second up on that stage. Well, here we are again, folks. Back at Chi-Chi's Cheesy Cafe where Kane is researching something interesting.
Hello everyone. I was thinking about what happened during our last show and thought it might be useful if we build other animatronics to have in our cafe.
But you will make sure to run this by Chi-Chi before enrolling, won't you?
Of course. I promised her I would run things by her after what happened during the last show.
Heh, yeah.
I got your message, Kane. What's up? Ah, Chipmunk Chi-Chi. Visiting again?
Yep, just visiting this time. I was helping Kane research something that would be good for the cafe's business.
But I wanted to make sure I ran this by you before we did it.
What is it?
Well, I was thinking we could enroll you into an engineering class so you could learn how to build your own animatronics. I might not be able to, because, you know, I don't have any arms. But you could.
Interesting idea. It would help if we had more attractions as opposed to just a little chicken and a cupcake.
So should I enroll you in?
I can do it myself. I need a laptop. Now, let's see here. I'm not sure about this teacher. He looks a little strict.
You shouldn't judge him based on his appearance. He could be a really good teacher.
Well, okay then. I'll fill out the enrollment form.
Awesome!
Well, here we are. My letter got approved and now I'm officially a student at Functioning University. I sure hope it's functioning properly. Oh, that's the bell. I better get to class.
Good morning, class. I'm Professor Bolt, and I will be teaching Engineering 101. By the end of this course, you'll have full knowledge on how to build a functioning animatronic. What do you want, Red Chicken?
I was just curious about something. Will these animatronics have lifelike qualities like we do?
That was a very stupid question, and stupid questions are not welcome in this class. You may leave and not come back for the rest of the day.
What?
Come on, mate. At least we're off with a warning.
I don't appreciate you talking without raising your hand, mister. You're cut for the rest of the day, too.
Oh, man.
Now get out of here, you two.
Man, why did we have to get Professor Bolt for this class? He should be called Professor Nut.
Yeah, he should. Thanks for sticking up for me in there.
No problem. Name's Tuck.
Chi-Chi, nice to meet you.
You too. So you're new to engineering, clearly.
Yeah, I am. I wanted to learn how to build animatronics for my cafe. I guess having lifelike ones isn't something you can just learn at a place like this.
Well, you can, but you have to make it to the advanced class. That means sitting with Bolt for a whole year.
A whole year with him?
Yep.
Well, I guess if that's what it takes, I'll do it. I'll just have to study up a bit more so I'm not asking stupid questions.
Well, don't worry. The advanced class is taught by Chiyo, and she's much nicer than he is. You two actually look a lot alike.
Interesting. Well, if I'm kicked out for the day, I may as well go back to the cafe. Wanna come?
I would, but I'm also studying medicine later today, so I should stick around.
Ah! Are you aiming to build a robot nurse or something?
Yeah, having robots in hospitals during Christmas time could let the doctors be with their families.
Aww, that's nice. I'll see you in our next class.
Yeah, see you then.
I'm home!
That was quick. This bulk guy must be a fast talker.
No, I got kicked out for the day.
What? Why?
I asked if the animatronics would be lifelike and he said he doesn't like stupid questions in his class. I'm gonna have to be careful what I ask around him.
Oh, wow.
I got these textbooks on the way home, so I'm gonna study up. I'm sure in Engineering 101, missing one class could cause you to fall very far behind.
Good idea. I'll be sure not to disturb you while you do that.
Thanks!
No worries. I can't wait to have other animatronics here.
So Chi-Chi's classes have been a bit rough so far, but as long as she works hard, I'm sure she'll keep up. Maybe even get ahead. As for Kane, he feels lonely sometimes and can't wait for new animatronics. But how will he cope until she graduates? We'll just have to see next time. Hello once again, listeners, to a new episode of Chi-Chi's Radio Show. But this time, we won't be starting our adventure off at the cafe. Instead, we'll be starting off in the forest where Chipmunk Chi-Chi resides.
Hey there! Just chilling in my burrow. It can be a bit boring sometimes, but at least the wildlife is nice to look at. I just wish I had more friends out here. All my chipmunk friends go to school with me, but they've got their own personal situations which I can't help much with. So after school, I'm here. Alone. That's why I visit the cafe so often. I can't today, though, because Chi-Chi's at her engineering class and Kane's off learning some kind of trick for a new show.
Hey, Chi-Chi!
Ow!
Are you okay? I didn't mean to scare you like that.
It's alright. I thought you were learning a new trick.
That's what I told Chi-Chi. I just wanted an excuse to leave the cafe for a day.
Wow. You sneaky little cupcake. Whoa, don't come inside! I've got sticks everywhere in here.
Wait, you live in that thing?
Well, I am a chipmunk, so it makes sense.
But you're a human-like chipmunk.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means you act more like a human in some areas. I mean, you're going to school, you're wearing clothes, you have an amazing singing voice. Just the fact that you can talk really sells it.
Yeah, you have a good point.
Anyways, I might continue my nature walk. Want to come with me?
Sure.
You know this forest better than I do. Where's a good spot to explore?
Well, there is a dark cave I've never been in. It looks really scary.
It might not be that bad. Lead me to it.
Okay, then.
Wow, that does look intimidating.
I know. That's why I've never gone in before.
It could be full of hidden treasures, though. Have you thought of that?
Even if it is, it's probably guarded. The first time I was here, I was with a chipmunk friend named Jack. He went in there and judging by the swarming bats and screaming, I don't think it's safe for small creatures like us.
Well, only one way to find out. Come on, I'll protect you.
Okay then.
It's pretty dark in here.
Yeah, no kidding.
I'll see if there's some sticks here. We might be able to make a torch to light up the cave.
I think I see some.
Ooh, perfect. Much better. See? This cave doesn't seem so scary.
They have us surrounded! What do we do?
Wave the torch at them. Bats don't like light.
Get back!
Good. Now keep that up until they go away.
Is that seriously your plan?
Yeah. It's not like I've had practice in this sort of situation. Wait. What's that noise? Chi-Chi, get down!
Stupid bats! You two, get out of here!
Okay!
Thank you! That was close.
I warned you about that cave! We would have been killed if it wasn't for that thing with the fire coming out of her mouth!
What was that thing anyway?
I don't know. I didn't get a good look at her.
Well, either way, we should consider ourselves lucky. Next time, I'm gonna make sure to bring a better light source.
Are you kidding me? Why would you want to go back in there?
Well, we still never got to explore the cave. One day, we'll go back in there and discover all its wonders. Together.
Well, as long as we're safe, I'll join you next time.
Thanks, Chi-Chi.
So the two of them made it out okay, but who was the creature that saved their lives? What truly lies within the cave's walls? We'll just have to see next time.
Welcome back, everyone. I bet you were on the edge of your seat last episode. Well, now it looks like Kang and Chipmunk Chi-Chi have gathered at the cafe to figure out who their savior was, as well as that Chi-Chi is doing some digging on the advanced teacher who supposedly looks like her. A lot of mysteries to solve, so let's head in and see their progress.
What's up, guys? We're in full investigation mode today. I wanted to take this weekend as an opportunity to look at Chiyo, because Tuck said she looks a lot like me.
Maybe she's another Chi-Chi from an alternate universe.
Possibly.
Meanwhile, we really want to find that creature who saved us back in the cave. We really owe her a thank you.
I'm still not happy with you lying to me, but there's no use focusing on that now.
So, Chi-Chi.
Yeah?
I meant Chipmunk, Chi-Chi.
Oh, okay. I said before this would get confusing. At least this potential Chi-Chi has a different name.
Chipmunk, Chi-Chi. Are you sure you don't have any other friends living in the forest with you?
Yes. My only friends outside of you guys are my chipmunk friends from school. That creature seemed way too tall to be a chipmunk.
Yeah. What if we went back in the cave with some better light and pretended like we were being attacked again?
That's not a nice way to meet your savior. She must live close to the cave if she could hear us screaming in there.
Good point. Maybe we could just go look around the trees and burrows close by and see if she's there.
Sounds like a plan.
Hold on. I don't feel safe with you two going near that cave again. I'll come with you.
But what about Chiyo?
I'll find your info later. I care more about your safety.
Alright. I suppose you could find her on campus anyway. We better get moving because she might already be off somewhere for all we know.
So this is the cave you two were attacked in?
Yep. This is the one.
She could be hiding in there.
Who in their right mind would willingly go in there?
Us?
Shut up.
And so would I. I'll just activate my light beams.
Activate what?
Light coming from your eyes? I guess we should make sure we don't lose sight of her. Get it?
I get it.
Come on, you two. Hop on my shoulders. Doesn't look like there's much here. Why were you so interested in this cave?
I thought there might be treasure here.
Well, at least there's no bats here.
Thanks to my eye beams of guidance.
And thanks to those beams, we've made it further than last time. Oh hey, I see a stone door.
Let's check it out. It's really heavy.
Oh, I want to. Oh, right. I don't have hands. It's not just a bed, it's like a whole stone house. Look at this little kitchen.
Guys? I don't think that creature was saving me.
Chi-Chi! Watch out!
Oh, crap!
And heroes deserve good houses, so he kicked me out.
Oh, wow. That wasn't very nice of him.
One day, I'm going to use my weapons to knock some sense into him before stabbing him with it.
Whoa, hold on now. There might be a way to solve this without getting violent.
How?
I'll tell you after you untie and free my friends.
Fine.
What are you guys talking about? All we could hear was muffling.
We're gonna help Branch get her proper home back.
G'day. Welcome to my way. You! What the hell are you doing back here?
Saviour! I demand my burrow back!
Branch was the rightful owner of this burrow, so she has the right to live here.
And if you don't budge, I'll go down to the head of the Forest Burrow government. He happens to be a big fan of my singing.
Well, you know what? If that's how you want to play it, fine. Do whatever you want.
Thank you. And there's a nice cave that you can move into instead. The bats are quite friendly, as long as you have a good light source.
You know what, Ranch? You can be like that. That's fine. But I'm just going to tell you this. You know Chiyo? Chiyo would never have treated me like that. Not ever. You hear me?
Wait! You know Chiyo! Damn it.
I knew Chiyo. She used to live in the forest.
Ah. She's actually teaching engineering, and I'm going to be in her class next year. Well, hopefully I'm going to be in her class next year. If I pass.
So the machines have brainwashed her into becoming one of them, passing on knowledge from generation to generation, so they will invade the forest and destroy it all!
I'm gonna lose my mind!
Guys, calm down! Machines didn't take over her. Well, I don't know that 100%, I haven't met her yet. But I'm hoping I can bump into her on campus at some point.
If you see her, tell her to come back to the forest and visit me. I've been quite lonely since she left.
Well, I'm only a short walk away if you ever want to visit me.
I'll keep that in mind. I'm sorry for reacting crazy when you came into the cave.
It's okay. You were just trying to protect your home.
Speaking of home, what do you say we get back to ours?
Good idea, Chi-Chi.
So Chi-Chi and Kane made their way to the cafe while the girls returned to their barrows. It seems like the mystery of the cave was solved, but there is still the mystery of Chiyo that's left to be solved. They do have some new friends who know her, so will Saviour or Ranch be able to help the gang out? We'll just have to see next time. Welcome back, everyone, and you're just in time because Chi-Chi's preparing herself backstage. Let's go check it out.
What's up, guys? I've decided to put together a show for some of the new friends I've made. I thought it could be a good way for them to all meet each other. Problem is, I'm a little nervous to perform on my own, especially in front of Professor Bolt. But I hope he can see this and go a bit easier on me in class.
I'm excited to see what she has prepared.
Me too. I hope she's gonna sing like I do. I suggested it to her.
I assumed her talent would be showing off her sea engineering skills.
It's only a sea because you're such a strict teacher.
I would watch what you say, Tuck, or that sea might just be brought down a bit more.
I don't understand why I have to be here. There could be evil masterminds to take down. There's damsels in distress to save. Like, come on, why on earth am I here?
You're here to repay me for stealing my barrel!
Oh, yeah. Still, I have better places to be, so I hope this is quick.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage, Chi-Chi!
Hi guys! Thanks for coming to the cafe. Hopefully we can have a fun night together. I'll kick things off with something I don't normally do, but Chipmunk Chi-Chi has taught me into giving it a go.
Hell yeah, I did!
I'm gonna sing a song.
Oh god, no.
Yeah, I'll just play the backing track.
Hey, this song goes for like 4 minutes.
4 minutes? I can't handle this for 4 minutes straight.
Hey,
you two,
shut up.
Oh wow, are you a Chi-Chi Psycho fan? I mean, look at you, you're dressed the exact same as she is.
That's because I'm Chi-Chi from another universe.
Jeez. Another universe? You are the most insane fan I've ever met. You probably killed someone to get here tonight.
Excuse me?
Both of you shut up, or you don't want to know where this boomerang's going.
Oh crap, why are they fighting? This isn't the one that I planned at all.
Come on, Chi-Chi, you've got this.
You pull my chair and
she's pretty good.
Yeah, I've heard better.
What's your problem, mate?
My problem is that I was dragged here. I barely know this chicken.
She's a really nice person, so you better stop complaining, or else I'm gonna punch you so hard you go back running to your cave.
Right, that's it. Come here, you badger.
Ah, guys, cut it out.
Yeah, you don't want to ruin the concert for the Psycho Dimension Killer here.
Why you? Yeah!
Everyone, please stop fighting!
Come on, guys, we're here to support Chi-Chi. Chi-Chi?
Where's she going?
Maybe check backstage. I'll try to break up these fights.
Okay. Chi-Chi? Chi-Chi, don't cry.
Putting this concert together was a stupid idea.
No, it wasn't.
I shouldn't have known they would start fighting with each other. Maybe I shouldn't sing in front of people, because that's what started the frowning.
No, Gigi, your singing was great. They should have just learned to keep their mouth shut. Sometimes you have to do something you don't like to support someone. And if they can't learn that, then maybe they are your friends. Talk of Ram, she's supportive, though.
Yeah, they did.
Don't leave them above things. And Saviour, he's just an entitled angel who doesn't get what he's listening to is the voice of one of the kindest people who ever lived.
Thanks, Kane.
Ah, come here, you.
You really are the most supportive friend I could ask for.
Thanks. Now what do you say we get back out there and continue the night?
Sounds good to me.
Oh, hey, Gigi. Are you feeling okay?
Yeah, a little better now.
That's great, because some people would like to apologize. Wouldn't they?
I'm sorry for complaining. Your singing isn't that bad.
I agree.
Ahem.
And I'm sorry for calling you a psycho fangirl. Maybe you are from an alternate universe.
I am, but we haven't thought about a theory as to how I got here.
That's something we can discuss another day. But for now, I think it's better to stick to what I'm good at. Kane, get my guitar. Chipmunk Chi-Chi, bring out the snacks.
Snacks? Never mind. Adventure can wait.
5, 6, 7, 8!
Good job.
That didn't sound too convincing.
Oh, it's just that Billie Eilish isn't that good.
Are you kidding? Her music is so deep and sad.
That doesn't make it good. You know you're very different from my Chi-Chi.
Yeah, we may be the same person, but our unique surroundings have made us into very different people.
Can't argue with that. I mean, one certainly has better music taste.
Why, you?
Okay, you two. We don't want to start another fight in here. Remember what happened last time?
Sorry, Chi-Chi. That smells good.
Oh, thanks.
Hey, Chi-Chi.
Yeah?
I know a song that could help set the mood for them.
Oh, you cannot be serious. He just said he hates Billie Eilish.
Come on. I think it might work.
Man, I can't wait to dig into this.
Yeah, me too.
Is she?
Just ignore her. She's doing this on purpose.
Anyways, did Bolt give you a decent grade for this semester?
Well, I think it was worse than what I actually achieved. I'm starting to think he doesn't like me.
Starting to?
Yeah. He didn't like me from day one. Probably because of that question I asked.
You do have to be careful with what you say around him.
Well, I wouldn't have known that. I only met the guy about 5 seconds prior. Seems you know a lot more about him than I do.
I'll be honest. I used to work here as a teacher.
No kidding?
Yeah. Bolt and I knew each other well, until he framed me for some damage caused by one of his animatronics.
That's horrible.
I got fired on the spot. That night, I found him in an alleyway and punched him in the face.
Oh, jeez. Is that why his jaw is just that little bit crooked?
Yep. He hates my guts because of that.
This isn't really a romantic conversation. In fact, it doesn't even really look like they're hitting it off at all. Just two friends having pizza and talking about talks upsetting past.
What about you? Do you have an interesting story from your past?
Not that I can recall. something. Me and Kane were built in a back room, but my design was a lot more nightmarish. We were built for a horror attraction. Soon after we woke up, I started to attack out of instinct. There was blood, screaming. I remember blacking out, waking up in a new body. No claws, no sharp teeth, no desire to hurt people. The memories of this screams haunt me wherever I go. I try to smile through it, but sometimes you just can't.
Oh, well.
Chi-Chi, you never told me about this.
It's not something I enjoy talking about.
I'm sorry you had to go through that.
It's okay. I've put it in the past, and I think it's best if we leave it there.
We're also sorry for trying to sing love songs during this time.
Yeah, we thought it would be funny. I wish you'd have done it.
It's okay, guys. Maybe it's best if we leave this night in the past, too. I mean, I had a good time seeing you, Tuck. It's just...
Yeah, I get it. I'll head home. Thanks for the pizza.
No problem. I'll see you in class.
Yeah, see you then.
I'm the bad guy.
I'll stop beating yourself up. Come on, let's go listen to something a little less depressing.
So it looks like Chi-Chi's past is out in the open. Her friends all understood, but will they react differently behind closed doors? We'll just have to see next time. Hello, everyone. Chi-Chi and Kang have gone out to pick up more food supplies, but little do they know, a rat is sneaking around the vents, looking for answers.
I'm not a rat! I'm a chipmunk! Anyways, hey guys! Chi-Chi isn't here, which is good. Her story from the other day made me freeze in horror. I couldn't believe that happened to her and Kane. I'm breaking in to find out more about what happened over there. Okay, I'm in. She must have some kind of evidence of the attraction's location. Let's check the office. Okay, let's see here. Aha! Here we go! Oh, it's a bit dusty. Skull Forest, the horror attraction. 1961! Jeez, she's old. Ooh, here's the address. Let's make my way over there. This doesn't look like a horror attraction. More like a lab of some kind. Ooh, there's a way in, through that vent. Man, a lot of vent climbing today. Big jump. Here we are. Wait. This all seems familiar. This looks a lot like a place Chi-Chi once described to me. The broken wood shards. That cassette player! The creature's roars! I'm in the abandoned lab! Oh crap! I have to hide! Crushing chicken and the killer cupcake. If successful, the subjects
Give up, Brad! You won't escape him!
Now, how did Chi-Chi escape originally? She used a ladder to get up to the vent! But wait, I can't use a ladder. Or at least a ladder that big. There has to be another way out somewhere.
Where'd you go, Brad?
And that's my cue to start looking. Come on. Oh, a sewer train. Not ideal, but it'll do.
Everyone, today is a very special day. It's Chi-Chi's birthday and everyone's at the cafe to celebrate. Let's go join the celebration.
What's up, guys? Welcome to my birthday party. I don't know how old I am, but it's still a special day nonetheless.
Oh, I know exactly how old she is. I don't know if I can wait with this anymore. I have to find time to tell her about what I found.
Is everyone having a good time?
Hell yeah, we are!
Alright, this next one's for you, Chi-Chi.
No way! I remember this song!
Oh, come on!
I'll only care about the party. I'm more concerned about stopping you. You have information that could destroy everything I've worked so hard for. I have to kill you right here and make sure it's for good.
Fine then. I may be fighting a losing battle here, but Chi-Chi's my friend, and I'm gonna do what's best for her, no matter what the cost.
You can't have a relationship like that. Huh? Are you okay? What happened to you?
Nightmare Chi-Chi. She's...
I'm back.
Was this planned?
No, it wasn't. And yet, she felt like she needed to crash the party. Now don't go blaming me. The rat was the one who brought me here. What?
Chi-Chi, I found information files about you at the abandoned lab.
Well, what information? Information that you're going to keep your mouth shut about, rat.
This monster has annoyed me long enough. Prepare to get a spear in the face.
Whoa, calm down. We don't know what she's capable of.
Okay, this is a bigger army than last time. Who are these people? These are my new friends. Something that you'll never have.
Enough chatting. Time to die.
Impressive, right? How were you able to obtain those powers?
She experimented in the abandoned lab. The lab you and Kane were created in.
Wait, what?
Yeah, you were built in 1961 and—
Silence, rat! Hey! I've had enough to hear with you. First you crashed my birthday, my 59th birthday, might I add. Then you start attacking my friends. I'm not gonna let that fly.
We won't let that fly. DJ, play us something epic.
Will do.
You may have powers, but we have an army. And we will rise! Haven't practiced much with these powers in combat. Also, that's why you sucked. I'll screw you!
Where did she go?
Away to fight another day. We'll know what to expect next time, but we can prepare accordingly.
But for now, could we continue the party?
Sure. Chipmunk Chi-Chi, show me those files after the party.
I had to leave those in the lab in favor of escaping a giant robot monster.
That stupid thing's still roaming around? Alright. We'll head there tomorrow, armed. Maybe we can even see if Katie's up for round two.
So the party got back underway, and Chi-Chi finally got to experience a party surrounded by her friends, even if she did frown when they made fun of her age every now and then. Anyways, that's all for this episode. Hey everyone, welcome back to Chi-Chi's radio show. Today is quite exciting as Chi-Chi's going to finally discover her origins with the help of an old friend.
Well, we haven't got her help yet, but we're really hoping to. Are we almost there?
The app says we've only got 6 kilometers left.
This would be so much easier if we had a car.
We're an animatronic chicken and a chipmunk. I don't think a car is something we'll ever have.
You never know. Chi-Chi's Juicy Cafe might do delivery one day.
Yeah, give it like 2 years.
Hey Chi-Chi, need a lift?
Sure! See? Animatronics can have cars.
Just because they can doesn't mean they should. Also, LMFAO, you had a go at me for liking Billie Eilish and meanwhile you're cruising along the party rock anthem?
This song is a classic. Something your generation wouldn't understand. Besides, this was the only CD in here.
Yeah, sure.
I've only been able to get into a couple of modern songs. All my favourites are from around the 60s and 70s.
I wonder why that is, Grandma.
Where to, girls?
Katie's School of Dance.
Oh, you've told me about her before. She's that fox with the aquamarine hat, right?
Yep, that's her. I haven't seen her in so long. She's had time to open her own dance school. I hope her business is better than how mine is right now. Only 2 attractions with occasional appearances from Chipmunk Chi-Chi, no human employees, and a very poor food contract.
It'll definitely improve next year when you finish the advanced class.
If I even make it to the advanced class. Last semester's grade didn't look promising. I know probably did better than what Bolt gave me. I just hope he doesn't fail me.
Here it is, girls. Katie's School of Dance.
Thanks for the ride!
No worries.
Just quickly, how did you obtain this car anyway?
That's him, officer. The guy who stole my car.
Gotta go. See you in class.
And he's a bad boy, too? Seriously, just go for him already!
Oh, shut up!
How can I help you, girls?
We're here to see Katie.
Do you have an appointment?
No.
Then you may not see her. She is a very busy woman, you know.
But we really need...
I got this. Look, ma'am. I'm Chi-Chi's Star Monk. As a celebrity, I should get to see her with no hassle.
Chi-Chi's Star Monk? But didn't the Star Monks break up?
Yeah. But I'm still flying solo.
Yeah. If I recall correctly, isn't one member dead? Two out of state, and two others are starting an LGBT uprising.
Damn it, these chipmunk friends of yours sound really interesting.
Anyways, no one gets special treatment here, so you'll have to make an appointment like everyone else.
Chi-Chi?
Hi, Katie!
Ah, Chi-Chi! Long time no see. Come here, I'll give you a tour.
With pleasure.
Don't worry, Rachel, they're with me. Hopefully she wasn't too hard on you guys. I just hired her recently.
Oh no, she was lovely.
No, she was. Ow!
I take pride in my students, both humans and robots. I believe we can use our different strengths to create a dance like no one's ever seen before.
That's really cool.
Yeah, it is. Now we should probably get to why we're really here.
Yeah, I suppose we should. Katie? Do you remember the lab we went to last year?
I'd rather not talk about that. We almost died in there.
Yeah. Wanna head back there again? I'll take that as a no.
So I guess it's just the two of us going in?
Yep. Seems like it. Man, it looks even worse than the last time I was here.
I can't imagine it looking any better than this.
So where did you find my files?
Oh, this way. There they are, scattered on the floor.
Huh. Did you ever just consider grabbing this tape with my name on it?
Oh, I probably could have been able to carry that. Though I would have lost it when Nightmare Chi-Chi shot me.
Wait, what? Why didn't you tell me any of this?
I wanted to, but you were planning your goddamn birthday!
Tell me, I would have understood.
Ah!
Uh-huh.
Oh, right.
Come on, Chipmunk Chi-Chi. It's time to take this beast down.
Take him down? Who do you think you are? Some kind of tiny goddess? Also, we're the only ones here. Just call me Chi-Chi!
Hey, buddy. Remember me? Shoving you up. Does it still hurt?
Don't make him angrier.
I want him to remember who he's dealing with. I'm not the same chicken I was the last time I was here.
Literally. Your costume is completely different.
This idiot gave me the opening I needed.
Oh, right in the other eye.
to Kane. He can still know the truth. He won't know if you wait here with me.
I'm not gonna leave you to die here.
Chi-Chi's body on the way out.
No. No, she can't be dead. I refuse to believe that.
Well, you guys are animatronics. Could she be repaired?
He stabbed her right through the endoskeleton. It would have to be repaired by someone with really good engineering skills. Chiyo!
Chiyo? But we've never even met her.
True. But as soon as we tell her the truth about who she is, she'll help us. Functioning University is too far to walk from here. We're gonna need a ride.
I might have one.
What are you beeping at me for, mate? You're the one driving like an asshole.
New music. So does that mean you actually pay for this car, or is it another stolen one?
Stolen.
Well, whatever helps us get Chi-Chi fixed, I guess.
The damage needs to be attended to fast, otherwise she won't make it. I'm gonna have to speed a bit.
I don't think the extra seconds on the road makes up for the months we'll spend in prison if we're pulled over in a stolen vehicle.
Oh, come on. He's trying to help us, but he could be studying for his final exams.
I'm happy to help Chi-Chi out anytime she needs it.
As any good friend would.
Yeah, friend.
Does he like her?
Hopefully. I ship him.
Ooh.
I can hear you back there.
Oh.
Oh, Secretary. We think you and Chi-Chi are so cute together.
Is that why you were singing love songs during our pizza dinner?
Yes.
Well, I just like her as a friend. I actually have a girlfriend back in my hometown.
Oh, man.
Chi-Chi will find a boyfriend eventually. Hopefully. I just want the best for her.
You don't have to have a boyfriend to be happy. Me and Liam broke up, but I'm doing okay.
Oh, really? Sign here.
No, I'm fine. Ooh, is this the place?
Yep, this is it. Give me Chi-Chi. I know where Gio's office is.
Kaden, can you get that?
You know, I always come to see you. I don't get why you always send me to the door.
Oh, hello.
Our friend Chi-Chi's dying and we need Chiyo to fix her.
Sorry, but Chiyo's busy marking some
assignments. Wait! Did he just say Chi-Chi?
Yes, he did.
Holy crap! Hang on. I'm coming.
Oh, cool!
This is her, Kaden. The original version of me.
Wait, you know about the alternate universes?
Yeah. I've been studying it ever since I first saw Chi-Chi on campus. I'm a huge fan of her work, by the way. That's why I changed me and Kaden's names. I would never want to disrespect my OG girl.
Less talking, more life saving.
Oh, right. Sorry. Give her here. I'll take her back to my workshop immediately.
So you're another version of me?
I must be.
This is so cool.
Yeah, it is. How much longer, Chiyo? It's been 3 days.
I don't know. The damage isn't such a simple fix, even for me. Even if I manage to bring her back, she might not be the same. Oh, why did she think she could take down a lab beast with just a crowbar? Her body's too weak for something like that.
Oh. Well, Kane has been waiting out here the whole time.
I can't go back to the cafe. I'm worried about Chi-Chi.
Oh, I understand. I would feel the same way if something happened to Kaden. He was my first successful animatronic, after all.
I think we should let Chiyo get back to work.
Okay.
Come on. Please. Oh my god! Chi-Chi? I did it! Woo!
What's going on? The tape! Where's the tape? Where's Chipmunk, Chi-Chi?
Chi-Chi, calm down!
What the hell's going on here? Who are you?
Whoa! Calm down, calm down. Okay, hi, I'm Chiyo.
Chiyo?
Yes, Chiyo. And your endoskeleton has severe damage that I was only able to temporarily repair. You have to meet with me once a month to do checkups.
Oh my god.
I recommend you rest here for another hour before heading back to the cafe.
But I've got so many questions to ask.
Well, Kane is outside with Kaden. He can update you on everything. Kaden!
Yes? Oh, Chi-Chi, you're finally awake. Kane, come inside.
Oh, Chi-Chi! You're okay! Oh, I'm so happy to see you.
Yeah.
Oh, Kane and I got you girls out of the lab. And Chi-Chi made sure we remembered the tape.
Really?
Yeah. We'll listen to it once we get back to the cafe.
You have no idea what it was like seeing you dead right in front of me. I'm surprised you survived it, man. Maybe you are the kind of
person. Can we please stop talking about it?
Okay. Anyways, it's good to have you back. I'll make sure to text Tuck and Katie later. They were a big help.
Here's the tape.
Perfect. Pop it in.
Professor Simon Drew, Value Laboratories, 1961.
Yep.
I've assigned experiment number 450, Lifelike Animatronics. I think they did such a good job on her design. She's just the most adorable thing. I never gave her a name, and I think if she's going to be lifelike, she needs a name. Oh, thanks, May. I'll call her Chi-Chi.
I'm not the nightmare experiment.
Enough stalling. Let's see if I can activate her.
Where am I? Oh, hey, Brenda.
Oh my god. It worked!
What worked?
Oh, you have no idea. I've been working on you for months now. Oh, Wendy, you're just in time. I finally got her active. Her name's Chi-Chi.
Hi, Wendy.
Hello? Look, it's perfect you were able to get her operating. That means we have a successful model to use on future experiments. We actually got a deal with Skull Forest, the horror attraction, to produce a lifelike nightmare animatronic. We can use this model as a base. I even think she could have a little devil cupcake as a companion.
Why a cupcake?
My daughter drew one based on a nightmare she had. I thought it looked cool.
But she's too cute to be a nightmare animatronic.
I believe the engineers will find a way to make her design scary.
Okay. You truly are one of a kind. I don't want them to keep using your cute design for any more horrible experiments. Here, come with me.
Where are we going?
To freedom. I've just got to turn this off.
So I'm not a murderer? Oh, you have no idea how happy that makes me.
That still doesn't explain how you have no memory of this. Yet you remember Nightmare Chi-Chi's origin, despite not being there.
I think Nightmare Chi-Chi might have the answer. But honestly, I don't know if I want to think about her anymore. I have a feeling she's responsible for what happened to me. I need some time alone.
Well, I did say she might not be the same.
So, quite a lot has happened in this episode. Unfortunately, the old narrator is dead, so I'm here to take his place. Welcome everyone, here we are at the Functionaries University. Chi-Chi and Tuck are sending their final exams and their tiny friends are waiting outside, trying to contain their excitement.
Hello everyone, me and Chi-Chi are waiting in the courtyard for Tuck and Chi-Chi to do their exams. I really hope they pass.
Me too. This campus is actually really beautiful. I don't mind just waiting out here in the sun.
I agree.
You know, Chiyo got me thinking about something.
Oh? What is it?
She said she changed her name because she didn't want to disrespect Chi-Chi. There has been so much confusion between the two of us. So, should I change my name to save everyone the trouble?
No! Well, it's up to you, I guess. I don't think you should change your name just because you feel like you have to. Chi-Chi was the name you were born with. It's part of your identity.
Yeah. Identity based on someone else.
Chi-Chi?
Ah! Hey! What's my
tail? This way! Up a tree! Alright, keep your eyes out for the two of them. They could be anywhere.
Hey!
Ah! Oh, hey!
How do you guys think you did?
I'm a little worried, to be honest.
Same. Being mechanically dead for 3 days definitely would have cut out some study time for you.
Please! Don't bring that up.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Whoa, what's going on?
Oh, I must have put the marks out already.
Let's go and have a look!
Alright, let's see. Tuck. 45%? I failed.
Oh no!
That's horrible!
I don't understand. I did so well.
Did you pass, Chi-Chi? Chi-Chi?
I didn't.
31%? 31%? Okay, that's bullshit right there. You did so much better than 31%.
85%! I passed! Woohoo!
Okay, that guy just sat at the back of the room on his phone all year. How did he pass?
That's it. Where's Bolt?
Chi-Chi, I don't think this is a good idea.
Hey, Bolt!
Let's see, guess. Obsessed with your grade? You should have done better.
I did enough to pass. You just downgraded me and Tuck because you hate us.
What proof do you have of that?
I have some proof.
Professor Chiyo, I don't recommend getting involved in this.
Chi-Chi did more than enough to pass. I've been looking over who would be eligible for the advanced class, and Chi-Chi would definitely be qualified. The only thing stopping her was your mark.
What about me?
Yeah, you passed too. Just barely, though. Your endoskeleton structures could use some improvements.
See? Me and Tuck passed!
So change our marks or we'll get you fired. Just like how you got me fired.
Tuck, be careful what you say.
No. I know you framed me for your robot's destruction. This seems like great revenge.
Shut up, Tuck. You got your revenge when you broke my jaw.
Guys?
I can break it again if you want to keep going with this.
What if I broke yours instead? I know more about animatronic parts than your tiny brain could ever know. Alright, my turn!
Okay, what's going on here?
Bolt was marking us down purpose.
He punched me in the face! Look at all this blood!
You hit me back!
Enough! You're both in the wrong here, so as the headmaster, I'll punish you both accordingly. Bolt, you're fired.
What?
Tuck, you're expelled.
What?
And I never want to see either of you on my campus again. Actually, Chi-Chi, Chiyo, I'm sure you two played a role in this too. You're both out of here as well.
What?
You can't kick out these, sir! They didn't do anything wrong!
Oh, you... I have no clue who you are, so I can't punish you.
Me and Kane don't attend here.
Oh, well then you're trespassing on campus. So all of you get out of here before I call the police. Go, piss off.
I hope you're happy, Tuck. You just got me fired.
At the expense of my own education.
Are you guys kidding me? I got fired and all I did was state the truth.
Enough!
Look, we're all guilty in some way. All we can do is accept the punishment and try and move on.
That's easy for you to say. I need to find a new job now.
There's probably something out there for you. They would welcome you with open arms. You've just got to stop clinging to the past. Believe me, I know what that's like.
I suppose you're right. You know, you're not that bad red chicken. Hope everything goes well for you and your cafe. Not you, Tuck. Hope you rot on the street.
You don't need him in your life.
What are you gonna do now, Tuck?
Well, I still really want to build my animatronic run hospital. I won't be able to without an engineering degree.
Does that mean you're going to study somewhere else?
Yeah. My backup school is in France, so I'll send an application there.
That's a long way from Australia. I guess that means we might not see each other again.
Oh man, you were a really good friend.
Thanks. You were a good friend for me too. And hey, thanks for driving me to Chiyo. It pretty much saved my life.
No worries.
Yeah, you must be pretty bummed about me and Tuck splitting up. I know you two have been shipping us.
No. What are you talking about?
Don't worry, we had a good talk about that on the car ride to Chiyo's. I have a girlfriend waiting for me in Paris.
Ooh, the city of love!
Yeah. What are you gonna do, Chiyo?
I'm not sure. I had this job to educate others and afford new parts.
I might have an idea. What if you worked at my cafe? You can be in charge of repairs and other stuff like that.
That's a good proposal. Are you gonna pay me?
Yep. It may start small, though. Without attractions, we're not getting many customers.
Well, I could help with that. I could give you some private mentoring focused on lifelike animatronics.
That would be amazing! Thank you!
You're welcome.
Everything worked out! Nice meeting you.
Yep, it is. Good luck with everything, Chi-Chi. I'm gonna put in my application and start packing.
Hold on, don't leave yet! I think we can give you a better send-off. What about a Christmas party?
Ooh, that sounds like fun!
I would love to go.
Yay! We can invite all our friends together for one last night of fun.
Can I invite some of my chipmunk friends? I'm graduating this year, so it's the last time I'm gonna see some of them.
Of course you can!
Woohoo!
There's one other person I want to invite. You may think I'm crazy because of what happened the last time she was at one of my parties.
No.
Yes. I ate some monsters from her. I think this is as good a time as any.
So, a Christmas party is being planned, but how will things go with Nightmare Chi-Chi being there? We'll just have to see next time. Merry Christmas, listeners! You're just in time to join us for Chi-Chi's Christmas party. Let's join them in on her now.
What's up, guys? I'm really excited for this party. The decorations look beautiful, we have some good royalty-free Christmas music, and most of the guests are already here. I'm not sure where Chipmunk, Chi-Chi, and her friends are, though.
I could give her a call, huh?
Good idea. I'll go see if you know who is here yet.
Yeah. All right. If she is, good luck.
Thanks.
Hey, you kind of caught me at a bad time.
Oh, sorry. I just wanted to know how far away you and your friends were.
Well, what is it?
I don't know. She didn't tell me. She even said not to worry about her.
Well, she said she can handle it, then I think we should let her handle it.
Okay.
Yeah, come here, mate. Yeah, that's a Magno. Come on, you'll be right.
You can't be serious, mate.
What? Why not? Some alcohol will cheer him right up, eh?
There you are. What? How did you... I knew you liked to make an entrance. Sneaking around the back would have been a perfect one for you. Whatever. I'm confused on why you invited me to this party in the first place. Especially since what happened last time you had a party with me here. How did you get that time? You know full well how I got it. You have my memories, and I have yours. How and why? How and why? I just wanted to be loved like you did! What? You have my memories, right? So that pain you remembered? That all happened to me. All the failed experiments, the violent attacks, those were all me. This dying woman, she said to me, Chi-Chi was lucky to get set free. I didn't know who you were at the time, but after some digging, I found a security tape of the day you were made. That Simon guy, he put so much love into you, whereas I was born as a monster. Jeez. Okay, that's the why. What about the how? How did you switch our memories? The day we met. I kidnapped you, stripped you of your costume, so I could access your memory chip in your endoskeleton. All I had to do from there is replace mine with yours. But you said you didn't take over the channel for Halloween! That was a cover-up of why I had to really kidnap you. The only reason I continued to talk was because of that stupid chipmunk nightmare thing. Well, even with the new memories, I was still jealous of the life you had. That's why I wanted to make you suffer. Just like I've suffered for the past 59 years. Now, I understand that must have been hard for you, but what? What are you gonna do to fix the past? I can't fix the past. But that doesn't mean we can let it hold us down forever. Life is all about how we live in the moment. Nothing good can come from clinging to the past. 2020 has been a rough year, but 2021 could be a great chance for you to start over. Be the girl with happy memories. That's what made you do all this to begin with, right? Yeah. No! That doesn't change anything! It still happened, and it still made me the killer I am. Look at me! I look like a nightmare! Even if I wanted to change, no one would believe me. I would. You're not enough.
This party has been a lot of fun. I'm gonna miss you guys.
We'll miss you too, Tap. It's been a long time since I've had another animatronic friend.
I'm sure that won't be for long.
Ooh, stop the music! Chi-Chi, how did it go?
Not as well as I thought. At least I got some answers about how I got our memories.
Can you tell us?
No, I don't think I should. It's better to put the past behind me and focus on the future.
Alright then. Well, what do you say we get to unwrapping some presents?
Sounds like a plan! I hope you like it.
Aw, guys, you're so mad!
I'll touch you, Jonah!
Hope you like it!
Oh, come on, man, I'm trying to express.
Thanks for the present!
Man, that was quite a mess to clean up.
It sure was. Thanks again for the party.
No problem. I think it had a beautiful Christmas atmosphere.
Yep, I should go home the pack.
Alright, thanks for everything. I'll never forget you.
Me neither, Gigi.
Is that the result all above you?
Kane!
Yeah, I'll go now.
Good idea. You can take that mistletoe down. I'm gonna finish cleaning up.
Sorry, I'm late.
Gigi, are you okay? What happened at the prom?
It's a long story. I'll tell it to you tomorrow, because it's getting quite late.
Good idea. Oh, wait! Just the season of giving!
Oh my god! You actually got me a present!
Of course I did!
Aw, thank you! Oh, wow. This necklace is beautiful.
The Toy Store owners weren't too fond of a nightmare cupcake coming in and stealing the doll necklace.
No kidding!
And he's a bad boy too? Seriously, just go for him already!
Did you just use my own line on me?
Oh, by the way, look where you're standing.
Still under that mistletoe. I was gonna take it down before you came in.
Oh my god, you two.
Well, it looks like everything's wrapped up in a nice little bow. This brings an end to Chi-Chi's Radio Show Season 1. We can't wait to see you next year for more adventures with Chi-Chi, Kane, Chipmunk Chi-Chi, and the many friends they meet along the way. Thanks for listening!